Good morning, children. So in the previous video, we did how to post ledger entries, how to post journal entries in the books of ledger, and also we discussed how to balance various ledger accounts. Now in this part, we are going to discuss how to post an opening entry into ledger accounts. If you remember, in the chapter journal, we have discussed opening entry. Opening entry means what? Where various assets, the business is started with a number of assets and liabilities. We used to debit all the assets and we used to credit all the liabilities. So how such opening entry will be posted in the books of ledger, that we will discuss here. So the point which you need to remember is opening balances of all the assets will be shown on the debit side of their respective ledger. Why debit side? Because we know the rule that assets have a debit balance. Accounts as to balance brought down. So all those assets in case of opening entry will be posted the balance on their respective debit side of their respective account as to balance brought down. Point 2. Opening balance of all the liabilities will be shown on the credit side of their respective ledger accounts as by balance carried down. Why they will be posted on the credit side? Because we know that liabilities carry a credit balance and therefore its opening balance will be posted on their respective credit side as by balance brought down. So let us begin with an example. Swati had following assets and liabilities at the beginning of the accounting year. Cash 10,000, goods 12,000, ash a debtor 8,000, bank loan 10,000, it is a liability, land 25,000. You have to pass the necessary journal entries and prepare necessary ledger accounts and also balance them on the basis of the following transactions. Received the due amount from Ash. Now, if you see the opening entry, what will be the opening entry? We will debit all the assets and we will credit all the liabilities. So, if you see the opening entry, what will be the opening entry? Cash account debited 10,000, stock account debited 12,000, Ash debited 8,000. Land account debited 25,000, to bank loan account 10,000. Now, when you total the debit and the credit side, the total of debit side is coming to 55,000, whereas the total of credit side is coming to 10,000. That means the debit, the asset is more than the credit or the liability. So, the difference will be transferred to capital account as we have discussed in the chapter journal. So we have transferred the balance, the difference to capital account, that is 45,000. Now coming back to the question, there are a number of transactions once again. Further, the first transaction received the due amount from Ash. That means Ash is a debtor and whatever the amount was due from her. What is the amount due from her? 8,000. Now the same amount has been received from her in full. So what will be the entry for this? Very good. Cash account debited 8,000 to Ash 8,000. The third transaction, redeemed bank loan in full. Redeemed means repaid. So whatever was the bank loan, that has been paid in full. So what will be the entry? Bank loan account will be debited because it is a liability. Therefore, it had debit balance. It had credit balance. And now since we are repaying it, so it will be closed. Therefore, it will carry an opposite, that is the debit balance, and since we are making the payment, so cash is going out, so the entry will be bank loan account debited to cash account 10,000. The third transaction, sold goods to Ram. The word cash is not here, not given, so we will assume that it is a credit sale, so we will pass the entry as Ram debited to sales 2000. Then rent paid, entry will be rent account debited to cash account 200. Received commission, the entry will be cash account debited to commission account 6000. Now if you see, we have passed all the journal entries. Now you have to see how many accounts will be prepared. So you will be preparing cash account, stock account, ash account, land account, bank loan account and capital account. Now since all these are a part of the opening entry, so on in account of cash, stock, ash, land, the opening balances will be posted on the debit side because these are an asset. The opening balances will be posted on to balance brought down as 10,000 in cash account, to balance brought down on the debit side of stock as 12,000, to balance brought down of 8,000 on ash, two balance brought down 25,000 in land account, and in case of bank loan account, on the credit side we'll write by balance brought down 10,000 because it is a liability, and in case of capital account we'll write on the credit side by balance brought down 45,000. Now in the next entry you need to prepare cash account and ash. Now if you see, we have already prepared cash account and ash in case of first entry. So while recording in the cash account is debited in the entry. That means you will not record the cash aspect, you will record the credit aspect. And what is the credit aspect? Ash is the credit aspect. Ash is being credited in the entry. Therefore, while preparing the cash account, ash will be shown on the debit side as 2 ash 8,000. And while preparing the account of ash, you will not record the ash, the credit aspect, you will record the debit aspect. And what is being debited in the entry? Cash account. So since cash account is debited in the entry, therefore it will be posted on the credit side of the account of ash as by cash account 8,000. Then the next entry is bank loan account debited to cash account. Now if you see, you have already prepared the bank loan account, you have already prepared the cash account. So while posting the entry in cash account, you will not record the cash aspect. That means you will not record the credit aspect, you will record the debit aspect. And what is being debited? The bank loan is being debited. So whatever is being debited, bank loan. Now bank loan is debited in the entry, therefore it will be posted on the credit side as by bank loan account 10,000. And while preparing the bank loan, as you can see, you will not record the bank loan aspect, rather you will record the cash aspect. And since cash is credited in the entry, therefore it will be posted on the debit side as to cash account 10,000. Then the next entry is Ram debited to sales account. Now if you see, in this case you need to prepare both the accounts, Ram also, sales also, because you have not prepared. So as you can see, the account of Ram, in this case you will not record the Ram aspect, you will not record the debit aspect, rather you will record the credit aspect. What is being credited? Sales is being credited. Now since sales is being credited in the entry, therefore it will be posted on the debit side as to sales account 2,000. And in case of sales account, you will not record the credit aspect, rather you will record the debit aspect. And what is being debited in the entry? Ram is being debited in the entry. And since Ram is debited in the entry, therefore it will be posted on the credit side as by Ram 2000. Next entry is rent account debited to cash account. For this you need to prepare two accounts, rent account and cash account. Cash account is already prepared. So while posting in cash account, you will not record the cash aspect, rather you will record the rent aspect. Rent is being debited in the entry, therefore it will be posted on the credit side as by rent account 200. And in the rent account, you will not record the rent aspect, rather you will record the cash aspect. And cash is being credited in the entry, therefore it will be recorded on the debit side of cash, on the debit side of rent account as to cash account 200. Coming back to the last entry, that is cash account debited to commission account 6,000. Now if you see, you need to have two accounts in this case as well, cash account and commission account. Cash account is already prepared. So in cash account, you will not prepare the record the cash aspect, rather you will record the credit aspect, that is the commission aspect. Commission is being credited in the entry, therefore it will be posted on the debit side as to commission account 6,000. And then you will prepare the commission account. In commission account, you will not write the commission aspect, rather you will write the cash aspect. Cash is being debited in the entry, therefore it will be posted on the credit side as by cash account 6,000. So these are the posting of ledger accounts. Now we will just go through how the accounts are balanced. It will be just a quick revision. While balancing the cash account, you will total the debit side and the credit side, and on totaling we found out that the debit side was greater than the credit side. That means the deficiency, there is a deficiency of 13,800, the total of debit minus total of credit. That you have shown on by balance carried down, because cash account is neither a nominal account nor it is related to goods. and then you have shown the subtotal 24,000. And since you are writing the buy balance carried on the credit side, it needs to be brought down on the debit side. So we'll write two balance brought down. And don't get confused, students make mistake here. In front of balance brought down, they write the total amount. No, you have to write the amount which you have written in carried down. Then if you see the stock account is related to goods. Stock account, the debit side, it was 12,000, credit side was nothing. So the entire amount of 12,000 will be transferred to trading account because it is related to goods on the credit side to make it equal. Buy trading account, 12,000. Then the account of ash, no balancing will be done because already automatically both the sides are equal. So therefore, we do not require to total. And remember one thing, children, this will be very much helpful and useful while you prepare the trial balance, the next chapter which we will be discussing. All those accounts which do not have any balancing figure or which have not been closed by transferring it to trading account or profit and loss account. That means account like ash over here, where automatically the debit and the credit side are equal. We did not calculate any kind of totaling or balancing figure or anything. Such accounts are not recorded in trial balance. Then land also, debit side total was 25,000, credit side was nil. So therefore the entire amount of 25,000 has been transferred on the credit side as buy balance carried down. And what we have written as carried down, we have shown as brought down also here as 25,000. Then while preparing the bank loan account, we found out that automatically it got tallied. Automatically the debit and the credit side are equal. We did not calculate any balancing figure, nothing. And therefore such type of account also, that means if we were preparing trial balance, we would have not recorded bank loan account there because it has automatically get tallied. Then capital account, credit side was 45,000, so, and debit side was nothing. So we have transferred the entire amount of 45,000 on the debit side, since the debit side was the deficiency, as two balance carried down 45,000. And what we are showing as carried down will be brought forwarded on the opposite side, that is on the credit side, as buy balance brought down 45,000. And don't get confused here, this 45,000 is not the amount of total, rather it is the amount which we have shown in the carried down. Then the RAM, the account of RAM also, debit side it was 2,000, credit side was nil. So we have transferred the entire amount of debit side to the credit side by balance carried down, and we have then shown the brought forwarded amount. Now the sales account is related to goods. On the credit side, we had shown buy RAM 2000, so we have transferred the entire amount of 2000 to trading account. On the debit side, to trading account 2000. Then rent account is a nominal account. So on the debit side, we had shown to cash account 200, and its balance will be transferred to buy profit and loss account on the credit side. Now since these are being transferred to trading account or profit and loss account, no balance carried down has been written, therefore we will not write the balance brought down also. And same is the case for commission account also, children. On the credit side, we had shown buy cash account 6,000. The entire amount of 6,000 cash will be posted on the debit side, will be transferred to the profit and loss account at 6,000. So this is the way how you need to close and balance the ledger account and how you need to post the opening entries, children. It is a very easy chapter, but it is a very lengthy chapter because you have to be very particular with the format. You have to draw the 8 columns again and again. So be very particular. Do label all the columns, children, because if you do not label the columns or you do not make the proper format, your marks will be deducted. This is the assignment based on this part, children. You have to answer the following questions in your register. You have to solve practical question 2 to 5, that means 2, 3, 4 and 5 of the chapter ledger from your accounts book by D.K. Goel. So go through the video, part 1 and part 2, revise the concepts, revise the example which we have discussed in the video. Do remember the points to remember, do remember the rules which I have told you regarding the balance carried down, the balance brought down, the starting with the word to, starting with the word by, etc. Because all these are very, very important points, and also be very particular with the format, children. And since it is a practical subject, it will be very beneficial for you to as many questions as you can practice, and especially do the ones which I have given you as a homework. In the upcoming video, we'll be starting with a new chapter, children. Till then, thank you. Take care.